This is Professor Michael Chapman. I'm one of the most experienced IVF doctors in Australia. I believe that an important part that I can contribute is to educate patients in relation to fertility, infertility, and all that that involves. These series of podcasts help to educate you. I hope they are helpful to you. If you wish to know more, however, I'm more than happy to have you contact me via email, which is profmchapman@gmail.com, or make an appointment to see me on 9138422. The second investigation we do is an ultrasound of the testicles. What we're looking for there is initially the basic size of the testicles. How big are they? And if they're a normal size, there can be great optimism that we're going to be able to get sperm. Most men with a poor production line, with high pituitary hormones, will have reduced testicular volumes. So it helps us towards a diagnosis. The other thing that ultrasound can pick up is varicose veins around the testicle called varicocels. And they play a part because they warm the testicle up beyond what is normal. I mean, to some extent, as we evolved, one of the reasons that the testicles dangle out and are not part of the internal body is that the best temperature for producing sperm is around 35 degrees, not 36.7, which is who run around is normally as a normal body temperature. So they basically swing in the breeze. But if they have varicose veins around them, that brings the blood at the temperature of the body and warms the testicle up and makes the whole production line go sluggish. So we go looking for varicose veins because that's something that has a potential to be treated and improve the situation. So that's an ultrasound. We also look for tumours as well because there is a relationship between the presence of a tumour in the testicle and low sperm counts. So men have been saved because they had low sperm counts and they had an ultrasound which showed early cancer and it was resolved. Then we go for, particularly if we are concerned about the production line being abnormal, is looking for genetic causes. So the first thing we do is check the genetic makeup of the male. Is he a good XY? 46XY is what we're looking for. Aberrations of that with an extra X, 46XXY, it's called Klinefelter syndrome. Sperm counts, sperm production is very limited to very small pockets in the testicle. It doesn't mean there aren't any sperm, but they will usually be azoospermic and have low testosterone levels. So we measure, we can do a blood test to test that basic thing. Then beyond that, in genetic abnormalities that we go looking for, particularly if you've got counts of under 5 million, what are called mutations. So they're little aberrations of the genes on the male chromosome. They're called Y deletions, missing bits. And if we find that, in most situations, that's a very poor prognosis. There are variations which are okay and we can find sperm when we do biopsies of testes, but in most cases that's not a good news. But at least we know where we are and we can move on to whatever the next step might be. So that's genetic testing, hormone testing, ultrasound, and then we move on from that to what can we do about it.
And don't forget that you can access all the previous episodes by going to our website www.theivfjourney.com and select IVF Journey Podcast from the navigation menu.